juga sampai in equilibrium. Kalau kita tengok konten yang ada, first kita akan belajar tentang sini konduktor, fokus kepada tiga jenis sini konduktor, silicon, gallium arsenide dengan germanium, thermal equilibrium, charge carrier in sini konduktor, BOS dan juga pemidirek intrinsic carrier concentration. Position open level for intrinsic semiconductor. Open atom. Extrinsic degenerate, non-degenerate semiconductor. Complete energization. Charge neutrality dengan position of Fermi energy level. Kita pergi bagian production. Advent of semiconductor have revolutionized our life since it is the basic of all integrated circuit and microprocessor. To distinguish between electrical properties of material, we can group them into three sections: conductor, semiconductor, dan juga insulator. The importance between conductor, semiconductor, and insulator lies in the number of free electrons. Perhaps the best way to consider the difference between them is to use band theory of solid. As we may know, electron in an individual atom are restricted to well-defined energy level, and energy change within atom only take place between one level and another. In solid, atoms are linked together, and electron can occupy a whole series of energy level group into band. The difference in energy between level within the band is very small compared with energy gap between band. Electrical properties between type of solid and another line in different arrangement of the bond. Gambar rajah band gap structure ataupun energy gap separate by material insulator, metal semiconductor. To make sure kamu boleh beza dari segi energy gap yang ada di antara ketiga-tiga material ni. Kita ada valence band, conduction band, band gap ni. Jarak di antara valence band dengan conduction band, larger band gap between valence and conduction band, area untuk elektron bergerak, free electron move between valence to conduction, move daripada valence kepada conduction band. Kalau tengok ni, very big band gap. Insulator punya sifat, dia tak boleh nak mengalirkan arus kebarangkalian untuk electron move between valence to conduction ni agak kecil. Kalau kamu tengok metal, sifat dia valence dan juga conduction band ni overlap. Overlap ni maksud dia bersentuhan lah antara satu sama lain. So dia tak ada gap. Electron move freely between valence to conduction. Okay, satu lagi adalah semiconductor. This one is semiconductor. Okay, beza dia kalau tengok semiconductor dengan insulator. This one ada band gap dia, large, very large band gap. Maksudnya jarak ni sangat sangat besar. Tapi untuk semiconductor actually very small compare dengan insulator. Katakan ada elektron dalam ni, dia nak move ke conduction ni, perlukan tenaga yang kecil saja lompat naik ke conduction band. Dan yang ni adalah perwakilan yang kamu kena tahu untuk lukis. Kamu kena tahu ni nak lukis benda ni. Kita ada valence band atau conduction band. Ni conduction band, ni valence band. EV untuk valence energy, EC untuk conduction energy, EG untuk energy gap. Energy gap ni di antara valence dengan conduction. Contoh ada elektron di valence band ni, untuk elektron move ke conduction band. At least lebih daripada EG ataupun sama dengan EG lah. Bila ada movement, ada free electron.
In semiconductor and insulator, there are external field. External electric field is applied to conduction. It's not possible as there is a forbidden gap which is absent in metal. In order to conduct, electron from the top of full valence band have to move in conduction band by crossing the forbidden gap. Example, silicon, where the forbidden gap is about 1 electron volt. The field that need to be applied to do this work will be extremely large. This distance between these two location is about 1 angstrom. 1 angstrom sama dengan 1 kali 10 kuasa negatif 10 meter. A field gradient of approximately 1 volt over 10 minus 10 meter equal to 10 kuasa 10 volt per meter. It's necessary to move an electron from the top of valence band to the bottom. bottom of conduction. The other possibility by which this transition can be brought about is by thermal excitation. At room temperature, thermal energy that is available can be excited to a limited number of electrons across the energy gap. The limited number account for semiconduction. Where energy gap is large as a diamond, the number of electrons can be excited across the gap is extremely small. Intrinsic semiconductor, the conduction is due to intrinsic process without the influence of impurities. A poor crystal of silicon or germanium is intrinsic semiconductor. Electrons that are excited from the top of valence band to the bottom of conduction band by thermal energy are responsible for conduction. The number of electrons excited across the gap, kita calculate menggunakan Fermi direct.